Hi friends, ladies and gentlemen, today I am going to discuss the topic Electronic Banking Services in Digitalization Era. This module 2.3 comprises concepts of electronic banking, various types of electronic banking services, and the transaction cost level investigation of electronic banking services in digitalization era. Information technology is very powerful in today's world, and financial institutions are the backbone of the Indian economy. Banking sector plays a significant role in the development of Indian economy. Today, Indian banking industry is in the midst of an IT revolution. Nearly all the banks in India are going for information technology based solutions. The application of IT in banks has reduced the scope of traditional or conventional banking with manual operations. Banks are using new tools and techniques to find out their customers' needs and offer them tailor-made products and services. So, banks need to optionally leverage technology to increase penetration, improve their productivity and efficiency, deliver cost-effective products and services, provide faster, efficient and convenient customer service, and thereby contribute to the overall growth and development of the country. The rapid advancement in information and communication technology, ICT, has had profound impact on the banking industry and the wider financial sector. It has now become a tool that facilitates banks' organizational structures, business strategies, customer services, and other related functions. Banks, with the help of IT, are providing their customers with the best technology-based products and services than ever before. In this context, we have to discuss what is the concept of electronic banking. Electronic banking is defined as an automated delivery of new and traditional banking products and services directly to customers through electronic interactive communication channels. Thus, electronic banking may be defined as a variety of following platforms like internet banking or online banking, telephone banking, TV-based banking, mobile phone banking, offline banking, etc. The visible presence of electronic banking was evident to the customer since 1981 with the introduction of the ATM, automated teller machine. Innovative banking has grown since then, aided by technological developments in the communications and information technology industry. What is actually electronic banking? It is an electronic connection between the bank and customer in order to prepare, manage, and control financial transactions. Electronic banking, e-banking, is a major innovation in the field of banking. Information revolution led to the evolution of internet, which led to evolution of e-banking. In this context, let me discuss what is the history of electronic banking. Today, information technology and communication is commanding banking field. In 1980s itself, Reserve Bank of India advised all banks to go for massive computerization at branch level. For this purpose, Reserve Bank of India constituted a working group to examine different issues relating to electronic banking and recommend technology, security, legal standards, and operational standards, keeping in view the international best practices. The group was headed by the Chief General Manager in charge of the Department of Information Technology and comprised experts from the fields of banking regulation and supervision, commercial banking, law, and technology. The bank also constituted an operational group under its executive director, comprising officers from different disciplines in the bank who would guide implementation of the recommendations. The working group, as its terms of reference, was to examine different aspects of internet banking from regulatory and supervisory perspective and recommend appropriate standards for adoption of electronic banking and made some suggestions regarding association with international banking practices, risk with e-banking, security to account holders' money, proper supervision and legal framework for the adoption of new technology. What is the role of financial models in electronic banking? E-banking is the newest delivery channel of banking services. It refers to several types of services through which a bank's customers can request information and carry out most retail banking services via computer and mobile phones. Digital insight, a financial model capturing the cost and benefits to financial institutions of implementing e-banking channels for retail and commercial customers. The insight model, a digital insight model, calculated net present values of the cost and revenues generated when implementing different digital insights e-banking modules, either separately or in combination. The drivers of profitability for e-banking institutions are increased revenues, operational and transactional cost savings, ability to generate cross-sales by encouraging traffic to the website, and the ability to retain customers through target marketing and maximizing the site's stickiness value. Indeed, the expense of offering internet banking is difficult to justify for smaller institutions on the basis of cost savings alone. These financial models calculated implementation and monthly operation cost, operational and transition cost savings, and new revenues attributed to electronic banking activities. In this context, it is very important to discuss what are the important major ECRM techniques, electronic customer relationship management techniques of banks in digitalized era. Recent developments in critical areas of IT have changed the way banks are managing their customer relationships. Some of the latest electronic customer relationship management techniques used by banks in offering new products and services to the customers are, first of all, internet banking. Internet is used by banks to disseminate information to customers about banks' products and services through their websites. Banks are benefited by vast reach, reduced transaction cost, direct marketing and cross-selling, build bank's brand, etc. Also, the customers are benefited by reduced cost, convenience, banking with the bank and not the branch, speed, better cash management, etc. Another technique is data warehousing and data mining. This technique is used to develop and use customer data to check their profile retention and loyalty patterns. They provide valuable inputs for retaining customers and developing products and services for the future. Another one is the common one, ATMs. The growth in ATMs has been fueled by a race among banks to expand their customer base by going in for more value-added services on these machines. At present, installed number of ATMs in the country is 1,800, which is likely to be more than 4,000 by next year. Another technique is telebanking or mobile banking. These services empower the customer with an instant access to routine queries and transaction or check bank balances. Computerized decision support system constitute another major ECRM technique. This is a practical tool which helps the bank managers and customers in optimizing investment decisions. This helps the banks in applying optimization techniques in functional areas such as asset liability management, optimization of investment portfolios, and asset portfolios through linear programming. Email is the common ECRM technique. Through this, banks can maintain the list of its best customers and inform these members through email the various services and schemes offered by the bank. These days, this is considered as one of the cheapest and effective means of communication. Another ECRM technique is computer networking. Networking among the branches of divisional, regional, zonal, and head office of banks provide access to customer database from the executive task. This will integrate the front office applications with back office requirements, thus generating MIS for branch managers and executives at the different controlling offices, including head office for accurate, speedy, and cost-effective customer services. Another one is customer smart cards. These cards are issued to key customers who carry all the relevant information, details of previous and repeat purchases to make it convenient for the customers to recall and for the banks to keep a track of the behavioral and purchase trends. Then, why electronic banking? Why it is important in the modern field? Financial institutions should base any decision to implement e-banking products or services on a thorough analysis of the cost and benefits associated with such action. Some of the reasons why institutions offer e-banking services. First of all, it saves a lot of operational costs. More than that, greater geographic diversification. It improved or sustained competitive position. More than that, increased customer demand for services, then new revenue opportunities. It also facilitates differentiation of products from others. A combination of regulatory and competitive reasons. Then, first of all, most reason is stress on branchless banking. Similarly, increasing volumes of banking transactions, providing customers with cost-effective services, enable financial transactions from anywhere and allow non-stop working time. Today's banks are offering various cost-effective products and services through anytime or alternative delivery channels. Then what is the role of anytime channels or alternative delivery channels? The spread of anytime channels will help the banks in saving cost of operation and enhance profit. In the present scenario, electronic banking services defined as a variety of the technology-based products and services. Banks, with the help of IT, are providing their customers with the best technology-based products and services through alternate delivery channels. Some of the services offered by alternate delivery channels were internet banking or online banking, telebanking, mobile banking, electronic mail, Infinet, cyber banking, ATM, electronic check facilities, electronic fund transfer, EFT, automated clearing home, magnetic in-character recognition, MICR, RTGS, real-time gross settlement, DMAT accounts. These technologies, when combined, can dramatically change how IT is organized and delivered within banks. There are also far too many services in banks that can be outsourced, like transaction reconciliation, settlements, customer data integration, kiosk management, etc. Then what is the scope and significance of this electronic banking in the digitalized era? The future of banking business very much depends upon the ability of the banks to develop close relationship with the customers. In order to develop close relationship with the customers, the banking industry has to focus on the technology-oriented innovations that offer convenience to the customers. Today, customers are offered ATM services, access to internet banking, phone banking facilities, and credit cards. These have elevated banking beyond the barriers of time and space. Therefore, customer-centric approach coupled with effective use of technology and resources speaks of encouraging signs for the growth in the sector. In this context, a systematic process for calculating and comparing benefits as well as cost of e-banking services are required. Therefore, the cost-benefit analysis will be conducted and aimed at two main things. First of all, to determine if it is a sound investment or decision. Another one is to provide a basis for comparison. Hence, to gain and sustain competitive advantages in the fast-changing retail banking industry in India, it is crucial for banks to understand the effectiveness of electronic banking strategy. Bankers should realize the importance of cost of benefits accruing from the opportunities emerging from the digital revolution. What is the problem emerging in the market scenario in the banking field? In the emerging market scenario, survival and growth is critical for bank to align its vision, mission, goals and objectives of customer satisfaction. In order to retain these customers, banks have to provide better quality services. More than that, the cost structure of e-banking strategy needs to be evaluated for analyzing the efficiency of banks. Therefore, one of the problems emerging in the changing banking scenario is whether the huge investments made in providing e-banking services are justifiable with the benefits or return aspects of electronic banking services. Then let me discuss what is the background of electronic banking in our country, in India. India is achieving a considerable growth rate after introducing economic reforms. The contribution of communication and technology is much more for achieving growth rate. India will become the third largest country for internet users in the world. In India, majority of the banks permit customers to interact and transact electronically with them. Such services include request for opening of accounts, requisition of checkbooks, stop payment of checks, viewing and printing statements of accounts, movement of funds between accounts within the same bank, querying on status of request, instructions for opening of letters of credit and bank guarantees, etc. Then there is possibility of vital role of the e-banking in the development of our country. Indian banks commonly offer certain kinds of e-banking products and services to the customers. The common e-banking products and products and services offered by Indian banks are ATMs, automated teller machines, similarly internet banking, mobile banking, phone banking, tele banking, electronic clearing services, electronic clearing cards, smart cards, step banking facilities, electronic fund transfer, EFT, etc. Then let me discuss what are the technological events of banking sector in India. Use of technology in expanding banking is one of the key focus areas of banks. The banks in India are using IT not only to improve their own internal processes, but also to increase facilities and services to their customers. Efficient use of technology has facilitated accurate and timely management of increased transaction volume of banks that come with a larger customer base. By designing and offering simple, safe and secure technology, banks reach a doorstep of customer with delight customer satisfaction. Let me discuss what are the major technological events in banking sector in India. Arrival of card-based payments, debit, ATM, credit card, that was happened in late 1980s and 1990s. Introduction of electronic clearing services, that was happened in late 1990s. Introduction of EFT, electronic fund transfer, in early 2000s. Introduction of RTGS, real-time gross settlement, that was implemented during March 2004. Introduction of National Electronic Fund Transfer, NEFT, NEFT, as a replacement to EFT and Special Electronic Fund Transfer, that was happened in 2005 and 2006. Then, what is the role of e-banking in digital economy? Advances in technology brought a lot of changes in all fields in performing their activities. Banking sector is not an exemption to it. So, banks have been using electronic and telecommunication networks for delivering a wide range of their services. The delivery channels include direct dial-up connections, private networks, public networks, etc. And the devices include telephone, personal computers, including the automated teller machines. With the popularity of personal computers, easy access to internet and World Wide Web, internet is increasingly being used by banks as a channel for receiving instructions and delivering their products and services to their customers. This form of banking is generally referred to as electronic banking. The emergence of globalization boosted up the activities of electronic banking. E-banking involves consumers using the internet to access their bank account and to undertake banking transactions. At the basic level, e-banking can mean the setting up of a web page by a bank to give information about its product and services. At an advanced level, it involves provision of facilities such as accessing accounts, fund transfer, and buying financial products or services online. Therefore, the electronic banking eliminates the disadvantages of mutual procedure like slowness, tardy, manipulation of records, etc. In this system, the transactions can be carried out 24 hours. The customers can view their transactions, print out their statements, can transfer funds, and can make payments. Besides this, many banks are providing facility to set up, amend or cancel standing orders. In India, with the advent of economic reforms introduced after 1991, banking industry has made significant progress in which e-banking is playing a crucial role. ATM, automated teller machines, that means neither avoids traveling with money nor any time money, but certainly implies both. Slim ATM cards are fast replacing confounding withdrawal forms as a convenient way of getting money from banks. A smart person no longer needs to carry a wallet full of paper money in his purse. All he needs to do is to fish out an ATM automated teller machine card, insert it in the slot, punch in a few details, and go home with a hard cash. And therefore, automated teller machines, ATMs, were the first well-known machines to provide electronic access to customers. It is operated by a plastic card with its special features. The plastic card is replacing check, personal attendance of the customer, banking hours restrictions, and paper-based verification. ATMs perform a number of banking functions, such as withdrawing cash from one's account, making balance inquiries, and transferring money from one account to another using a plastic magnetic strip card and personal identification number issued by the financial institution. The Indian ATM industry has seen explosive growth in recent times. ATMs represent the single largest investment in the electronic channel services for the banks. In India, HSBC set the trend and set up the first ATM machine here in 1987. Since then, they have become a common sight in many of our metros. Automated teller machines ATMs have gained prominence as a delivery channel for banking transactions in India. While the ATM is a great service for customers, for the banks it means immense savings on the cost of operations. While a typical cash transaction carried out in a bank branch premise would cost rupees 40, that in an ATM will only cost rupees 18, translating into a cost saving of rupees 22 per transaction. And this, there are various number of ATM networks. The ATMs of a bank are connected to the accounting platform of the bank through ATM switches. The interbank ATM networks facilitate the use of ATM cards of one bank at the ATMs of other banks for basic services like cash withdrawal and balance inquiry. Banks owning the ATMs charge a fee for providing the ATM facility to the customers of other banks. The ATM deploying bank recovers this fee from the card issuing banks are referred to as interchange fee. Banks with a larger ATM network treat interchange fee as an important stream of revenue. This interconnectivity of ATM networks provide access to the customers to use any ATM in the country irrespective of the bank with which the customer is banking. There are a number of ATM network switches such as CashTree, Banks, CashNet, Mitra, and National Financial Switch, NFS. In addition, most ATM switches are also linked to Visa or MasterCard gateways. Providing relief to millions of users, RBI has also said from April 1, 2009, customers using the interbank ATMs, ATMs of other banks, for cash withdrawals or balance inquiries will not be charged any fee. As of now, customers have to pay rupees 50 as annual charges for using the ATM facility of their bank, while charges ranging from rupees 20 rupees to 50 rupees per transaction are levied for the interbank ATM transactions. Customers are also paying anything between rupees 10 to rupees 20 for making balance inquiries through interbank ATMs. There are different kinds of ATM. While talk about the ATM services in our country, you have to know what are the different kinds of ATM. The first ATM installed in India was by HSBC in 1987 at Mumbai. There are different kinds of ATMs used by the banks for the customers according to location, links, card insertion, and loading of cash. First of all, on-site and off-site ATMs. ATMs which are situated at the premises of the bank are known as on-site ATMs, and ones that are located at some busy places are known as off-site ATMs, like food halls, railway station, bus stop, shopping malls, petrol pump, etc. Another kind of ATM is standalone and network. These which are not linked to the hub of the bank to which it belongs are standalone ATMs. But these ATMs are not popular nowadays. Networked ATM, on the other hand, are those which are linked to the branch and also linked to the branches across the country, which means a customer of a particular bank can withdraw money from any branch of any bank at any city. Another type of ATM is dip card and motorized, where the customer is required to dip the card and take it back to the transaction is known as dip card. The sensors of the machine identify the customer and greet him with a voice. On the other hand, motorized ATMs are very prevalent among all. In this, customer inserts the card in the machine and takes it back when the transaction is over. In some machines, the card is taken back immediately, whereas in some machines, the card automatically comes out when cash is withdrawn. Another type of kind of ATM is a front and back. Cash has to be regularly loaded in the ATM machines. In the front loading, the door of the ATM compartment is closed and cash is loaded, whereas in back loading, it is done behind the ATM and a message is displayed, please wait for some time. Some services are being carried on. The geographical distribution of ATM is very important in this context. That means regional distribution of ATMs became more balanced with the share of metropolitan, urban and semi-urban centers. In total, installed ATMs varying between 26% and 29%. However, metropolitan centers witnessed a marginal decline in the share of ATMs to 26.9% in March 2016 from 27.7% during the previous year. Semi-urban and urban centers registered a marginal increase in their share of ATMs. Then what about the growth in ATMs? The geographic reach of ATMs increased further as the number of ATMs installed increased to around 0.2 million as at the March 2016, an increase of 9.7% over the previous year. Public sector banks maintain more than a 70% share on the total number of ATMs. Foreign banks, however, continue to post a decline in the number of ATMs. And another electronic banking service is internet banking. The idea of internet banking is to give customers access to their bank accounts via a website and to enable them to enact certain transactions on their account given compliance with stringent security checks. To the Federal Reserve Board of Chicago's Office of the Comptroller of the Currency, OCC, Internet Banking Handbook 2001 defined internet banking as the provision of traditional banking services over the internet. Internet banking, by its nature, offers more convenience and flexibility to customers, coupled with a virtually absolute control over their banking. Service delivery is informational and transactional, that means conducting retail banking services. As an alternative delivery conduct for retail banking, it has all the impact on productivity imputed to telebanking and PC banking. Besides that, it is the most cost-efficient technological means of yielding higher productivity. Furthermore, it eliminates the barriers of distance, time, and provides continual productivity for the bank to unimaginable distant customers. Banks have traditionally been in the forefront of harnessing technology to improve their products, services, and efficiency. They have over a long time been using electronic and telecommunication networks for delivering a wide range of value-added products and services. The delivery channels include direct dial-up connections, private networks, public networks, etc. And the devices include telephone, personal computers, including the automated teller machines, etc. With the popularity of personal computers, easy access to internet and World Wide Web, internet is increasingly being used by banks as a channel for receiving instructions and delivering their products and services to their customers. This form of banking is generally referred to as internet banking. Although the range of products and services offered by different banks vary widely both in their content and sophistication. The internet users in various countries have immense growth potential. But only a small percentage of internet users did banking online. Further incentives provided by banks would dissuade customers from visiting physical branches and thus get hooked to the convenience of armchair banking. The facility of accessing their accounts from anywhere in the world by using a home computer with internet connection is particularly fascinating to non-resident Indians and high net worth individuals having multiple bank accounts. This cost of banking service through the internet form a fraction of cost through conventional methods. The rough estimates assume teller cost at rupee 1 per transaction, ATM transaction cost at 45 paise, phone banking at 35 paise, debit card at 20 paise, and internet banking at 10 paise per transaction. The cost-conscious banks in the country have therefore actively considered use of the internet as a channel for providing services. Fully computerized banks with better management of their customer base are in a stronger position to cross-sell their products through this channel. Then another type of electronic banking service is mobile banking. In India, mobile banking is considered the next big step in banking expansion, particularly in the rural sector. Mobile banking provides a banking interface at a low transaction cost using technology. Cost of an ATM transaction is 5 times that of a mobile banking transaction, and transaction at a bank branch is almost 15 times more expensive. Then, for the rapid expansion of mobile banking in India, a proactive participation of big technology players and communication companies with the banking system is important. Today, there are over 470 million mobile phone users versus less than 200 million bank account holders. Banking license to a joint venture between one phone company and an existing commercial bank with a specific mandate for inclusive banking can speed up the spread of mobile banking in the country. Therefore, mobile banking is the most viable option for financial inclusion as it involves less transaction costs. India is one of the countries having the highest number of mobile users. As per CAFRL 2013 report, out of 100 Indians, 72 use mobile, but only 2.2% use mobiles to pay bills, and 0.6% use mobiles for banking transactions. That is the situation in India. People in rural area constitute only 38.89% of total mobile users in India. In future, the mobile user segment in rural area will increase and provide good opportunity for banks to launch mobile-enabled rural banking products and services. Let me discuss what are the major advantages of electronic banking. This may be segmented into three ways: benefits for banks, benefits for small and medium businesses, and benefits for customers. Let me discuss what are the advantages offered to banks. First of all, it offers very low setup costs, capability to cater to a very large customer base. It saves a lot of operational cost. At the same time, banks can offer a lot of personalized services to their customers. Reduction of burden on branch banking is another attraction for banks. What about the benefits offered for small and medium businesses? To run its operations more effectively, it is very useful. Another one is lower cost than traditional financial management mechanism. What about the benefits for customers? Of course, it offers 24 hours a day, that is convenient, 7 days a week. Another attraction is cost reducing transfer fees. Similarly, speed, faster circulation of assets. Competitiveness, that is fostering competition in financial market. Similarly, communicate easily, then abolishing the uses of paper, offering one-stop shop solutions. The crux of this module, that is the cost saving aspect of electronic banking services. That is, banking system of 21st century is full of technology savvy based with lots of products and process. Technology enables increased penetration of the banking system, increases cost multiplier effect on growth and development. India is one of the countries that have effectively tackled huge volumes of paper instruments in cost-effective manner. Development in the field of IT strongly supports in the growth and inclusiveness of the banking sector by facilitating inclusive economic growth. IT improves the front-end operations with the back-end and helps in bringing down the transaction cost for the customers. Banks can save a large amount of cost on the transactions effected via electronic channels. To draw conclusions about cost-saving aspect of electronic banking services, some investigation into the transaction cost level is required. The transaction cost level investigation describes that as an RBI report. RBI report stated that cost of a bank transaction on manual mode is estimated to be in the range of rupees 45 to rupees 50, while it is around rupees 15 on ATM and rupees 4 on e-banking. This is almost consistent with the recent research conducted on the transaction cost level based on SBI. Activity-based costing, ABC, is one of the best tools to find out the transaction cost of electronic banking services. Based on the formula, transaction cost equals operation cost divided by number of transactions, the cost per transaction of each electronic banking services can be calculated. The recent research conducted on the transaction cost level can be taken into consideration. The electronic banking services like ATM, CDM, recycler services, internet banking, and mobile banking. This is also compared with cost per transaction of traditional banking services. Along with transition cost level investigation, the usage pattern of electronic banking services is considered for finding out the beneficial dimension of digital initiatives. Therefore, through this endeavor of transition cost and usage pattern elements, the cost-benefit analysis of electronic banking service is made possible. What about the cost dynamics? As bank services are a lot more complex than the products of a manufacturing company, a different approach is needed for defining the cost objects of banking services. The cost of a bank's product varies mainly according to the channel where it is affected. The channels comprise two major groups, like the traditional channels and e-channels. The traditional channels are defined on the basis of the type of human assistance. E-channels are divided into three: ATM, CDM, recycler, internet banking, and mobile banking. The transition cost of each banking services is computed by using the formula operation cost divided by number of transactions. The cost dynamics table depicts the unique cost structure of various transaction channels. That means how much cost incurred by a bank for each transaction channel for conducting one unit of transaction. In an average, ₹46.61 cost is incurred by bank for making one transaction in traditional channels. In the case of ATM, CDM and recycler transactions, cost incurred by bank will become ₹5, ₹5.5 and ₹4.35 respectively. The cost per unit of transaction of internet banking is 0.54 paise and in the case of mobile banking, it will reach to ₹1.88. This table of cost dynamics makes it clear that the most cost-effective channel is internet banking. For this calculation, what are the cost components taken into consideration? In order to understand the cost structure of a banking transactions, a detailed analysis of unit cost components are required. A number of separate cost components in e-banking and traditional channels were to be analyzed. For traditional banking, the most important part of expenses is associated with staff wages. For ATM, CDM and recycler services, machine cost is the highest cost element, but it was incurred in the initial years only. That is a peculiarity. Then IT operational expenses like servers and communication, software cost, storage cost, internal IT maintenance cost, etc. were taken into consideration for the cost measurement of internet banking and mobile banking services. Let me conclude. The efficiency of a banking sector depends upon how best it can deliver services to its target customers. Therefore, it is crucial for banks to understand the effectiveness of e-banking strategy and should realize the importance of cost saving from the opportunities emerging from the digital revolution. Hi friends, then through this module, we have traveled from the concept of electronic banking and finished with the importance of cost saving aspect of electronic banking services in the digitalized era. Thank you.